Mouth and chin area. Now remember, guys, if you're not in the area that you should be today, you are behind. You got to figure out a way to get caught up. If you guys follow me on Twitter, you saw that I posted yesterday a picture of an example of a project of what happens if you don't manage your time very well on that. I will admit, very concerned for a lot of you guys is that you've kind of held off getting caught up for a few weeks. And as a result of that, you've kind of created a situation where you have a ton of work to do and not a lot of time to do it, even if you have the extension. So keep in mind that extension, it does give you a week to get that project turned in, but what it doesn't give you is time here in class because we are moving on to the next project. So that means all that work that you don't have finished by the end of Friday, you have to do on your own, at home, and in your free time, okay? So keep that in mind. Now's the time to get caught up on this. Okay, so for your mouth and chin area, everybody, of course, is always in a different situation, different lighting, different face, different position, okay? So if you're in a position like her, she's got, if you guys notice, her mouth pretty much goes from really light, and you can see that the shadow on her dark side creates a pretty hard edge right here on her lips. Now again, you may or may not want to tape off for that, and it depends on how hard of an edge this is. Now I will tell you that she did tape off just the bottom, but she did not tape off the top of this. The reason being is because you can see that this edge here on the top shadow is a lot softer, okay? A lot of kids also too feel like, for whatever reason, that they might need to tape around their lips while they're inking in their lips. I don't recommend doing that either because, again, the thing you have to understand about your mouth and your lips and specifically is that your lips is just an extension of your skin. The reason why your lips stand out is because it's a different tone than your skin tone. So it's either darker or lighter. Depends. It's different for everybody, okay? But it's not because there is a hard edge right there, because again, it's probably a softer edge. I do not, again, recommend that you tape off to do your lips, okay? Now, one of the things I want to talk about is this midline. Now, that might be the one in one of two situations where you do actually need to put a little bit of a line, maybe. What you'll notice, though, a lot of times is that that midline is not straight across and it's not like a smiley face either, too. It's got a lot of dips and curves and angles and, you know, angles to it. So you want to make sure that you're paying attention to what your photograph is telling you. The other place that you might see some line work is that for some of you guys, you might see little wrinkles in your lips, and that's just because we talk a lot and so our skin gets wrinkled in that area. So when you look at a piece like this one right here, there we go, you can see that she actually does see, she sees some creasing happening on her lips. In that particular area, she did use the mat board or cardstock to create those wrinkles, okay? But on hers, she actually did not use that cart or the mat board or the tag board to draw a line in the midline. If you guys look for her, the reason why you see her midline is because it's darker on one side and lighter on the other. That's where you see the difference between the top lip and the bottom lip, okay? It's not because there's a necessary really dark outline that goes in between there. A lot of times it's because of a value change, okay? So you can see here, you see the difference between her top lip and her bottom lip because again, it's lighter here on the top and it's darker underneath that midline. That's why you see it. And then again, you don't see an outline around her lips here. The reason why you see the edge of her lips is because again, it's a value change. Her skin was darker here and it was lighter underneath the lips. Here it's still a little bit darker, but not quite as dark as there. But you can see that that's how she's showing her lips. Okay. You have other situations like on Sean, okay? So again, you see the difference between the top and the bottom lip because it's lighter here, darker underneath, and then he's got a highlight here on his bottom lip, and then he's got a shadow, sorry, he's getting a shadow underneath his bottom lip. A lot of you guys will see that because our bottom lips, if you touch your lips, they stick out right here in the middle, and as a result, this bottom lip, because it sticks out, you get like a little shadow right underneath there. That's another way we define our bottom lip. So it just sticks out there right there in the middle. On the sides, it does not stick out. It's just here in the middle, okay? So again, you can see how he's defining that. And again, his lips blend into all dark on the one side. Let's see here, let me show you this one. So we've got his lips here. You know, again, you see the difference between his top and his bottom lip because again, there's a value change. His top lip is lighter, his bottom lip is darker. And then of course, again, he does not have an outline around his lips to define the edge. It's because there's a value change between the skin that's around his lips and then the value of his lips. We've got one like right here, or again, you know, the reason why you see the edge of the lips is because the lips themselves are darker than the skin that's around there. You see the difference between the top and the bottom lip because it's shaded in the middle here. Your lips, they'll stick out here at the top, but when they kind of go in towards that midline, they kind of sink in a little bit. So again, you'll get some shading right there at that midline. You can see too, she's got some wrinkles in her lips. She did that with the map board and cardstock. So the point that I'm trying to make to you guys is one, you're not going to be taping off like you think you might need to on the mouth. You're not going to be drawing a lot of line work on here like you think you might, okay? The only place that you might be having a little line work are the wrinkles that you see there, and you may need a little bit here on your midline, but other than that, that's it. It's going to be a lot of stamping, okay? Now with the chin, again, the people kind of naively think that the chin doesn't have a lot to do for, or a lot that needs to be done for it, but what I want you guys to do is pay attention to the shape that those shadows are making, because that's what's going to form out your chin. That's what makes your chin yours, is those shapes of those shadows, okay? So you can kind of see, you know, look at that great shape right there. That's really giving it a lot of form. Again, look at that, see how that is. Again, look at how the edges are either soft or hard, or if your values blend together in grade 8. Again, nice shapes. It's all about paying attention to this stuff. A lot of you guys too will see some shadows happening around here. Because this part, again, they're little dimples, you know, so they kind of sink into our faces, so you get some shadows right there. I did that one. This one. Again, look at the shape. Okay? Do not, and because you're going to be in your chin area, do not, whatever you do, don't take necessarily your map board and cardstock and try to draw a line for your chin. Okay. Some of you may need it, some of you may not, the majority of you will not. You know, again, you see the difference between her jawline and her neck because it's shadowed underneath her neck. But that's something that you guys will kind of need to think about when you're working on the chin, because it's just connected to right here. Okay, so again, there's no line. The reason why you see it is because this is darker here, lighter there, darker, lighter. There's just a difference. That's how you see edges, okay? Same thing here. His actually kind of got washed out from the light. So you don't even see the edge. You know, again, a little darker right here, and that pops out that chin and the jawline. Okay? So there's that whole area there. I will post this video on Canvas so you guys can see it if you're not ready for that. I would definitely advise anybody who's not in the right place today to take your project home today if you can to work on it. So that's it. Good luck.